another thing, no, cause I'd rule the world. And you'd be right next to me running the show. We threw every rule in the book out and bring down the house. If you were my girl, we'd dream of... Aww, are you so pretty?
Shut up, Zach.
Aw, does someone have their panties in a bunch?
Really now? Are we going to start this now?
Nice costume, Dustin.
Yeah, you're so pretty.
I'm going to call you Dustiana from now on.
Hey, look. That stain is still on the ceiling.
Oh yeah, that memory was amazing.
No, it wasn't.
Not for you, maybe.
Hey, baby, want to work together?
Ew, no.
Fine. I'll go ask Sydney. Hey, partner.
Sorry, I'm working with Star.
Well, Madison's not here. Who am I supposed to work with?
Go work with Lexi.
Ew, no. How would you work with her?
I told you I'm working with Star.
I'll work with Star.
Yeah, I don't think so. It's a nice try, though.
Fine, I'll work by myself.
Wait, where are you going?
Outside?
She is so not going outside.
Totally. I'm going to go find where she went.
All right, let's go.
Does this outfit look okay?
It's really cute.
I heard the school is going to make all the students wear uniforms next year.
I heard that too.
Lame. But I'll do it.
Just get it over with, Dustin.
Okay, here I go. While I'm at it, I'm gonna get me a delicious apple.
That might not be a nice idea.
Why? It's just some random tree.
It might be some forest newt or an elf's tree.
Oh, shut up. Don't tell me what to do.
Be careful, Dustin!
Dustin, wake up. We have an issue.
What's so important that's to wake me up at 3 a.m.?
Abby got out of bed.
You woke me up because Abby got out of bed? Who do you think you are?
Will you shut up and let me finish? Abby got out of bed and is headed to the abandoned campsite.
Why in the world is she heading up there?
Don't know, but I'm not going alone.
What are you just standing there for? Let's go!
I just thought it sounded better that way.
Well, this play wasn't written to please you!
Connor, please don't be angry. It was an accident.
You're an accident!
Ow.
Don't be, Star. You didn't do anything wrong. It was that stupid Dustin. He said you thought of me as your brother.
Is that bad?
Well, it's just that I think of you differently.
Is he actually gonna tell her how he feels?
Mathison? Will you help me remake my sandcastle? Please?
Sure, why not?
Dang, I thought he finally had the guts to tell her how he feels.
Did I or did I not tell you that you were running out of time?
Yes, but you don't understand.
how much bravery one needs to do something like that.
If Zack and Connor can do it, why can't you?
I was scared. And now, I'm heartbroken. I lost the love of my life. And there's no way that her and Zack are gonna break up.
That's just the way life is, Madison. We are given these chances for a reason, and every once in a while you need to slow down and smell the roses. But you can't go too slow, because if you do, you'll miss great opportunities that the world holds for you. Star, for example. There was a reason she was single for so long. It was fate telling you that you need to make your move. And each day that went by, your heart knew that it was running out of time. This was God's way of granting you your wish, but you were too blind to see that.
I know! Reyna, it's hard. Really hard. I just want her to love me back.
Trust me. I know how that feels.
Dear Princess, you are my whole world, and I'd do anything for you. Even if it meant climbing the highest mountain just to see that beautiful smile crease over your beautiful face. Please, take these flowers and never forget that you are my princess, and I'm here to keep you safe. Love, Zacky.
Zacky? Zacky, wait!
Star, if that's how you feel, then we should just break up. You didn't have to humiliate me in front of the whole school. I should have known a girl like you loving me was too good to be true. Too good!
Hey, Star?
Yeah, Maddie?
What did you do?
What in the world are you talking about?
Why would you do that to yourself? And what about those pills I found in there?
You were going through my stuff?
How could you expect to keep a secret like this from me? You could have died.
Well, too bad I didn't.
Why didn't you come to talk to me?
Didn't know I exactly had someone to talk to. Did you ever think about that?
What you did wasn't okay. I'm leaving.
So why did you call us here?
You guys know why you're here.
We have no clue what you're talking about.
Well, since I overheard your guys' secret, I thought you'd like to keep a secret.
God, what are you gonna do to us?
Don't worry. It's not like I'm gonna take a million pints of your blood and then try to kill you.
So what exactly do you want from us?
Follow me. I want you guys to clean my garage.
Holy moly!
I never actually really liked you. I was hired to date you. My feelings for you were never actually real. I would say I'm sorry, but truth is, I'm not. Plus, you're just not my type. Honestly, you're too small, and I don't date brunettes. I date blondes.
That is super low, Blake! And after everything I did for you, and after everything I told you...
Sweetheart, you did nothing for me, and it seemed to me that your life was pretty crappy.
If you sensed that my life was kind of crappy, then why would you continue to lead me on?
Sweetheart, I've got to make money, somehow. Not everyone can rely on mommy and daddy for money.
That.
Oh, I'm so scared.
Screw you!
is she?
Savannah?
No, Michelle Obama.
Why are you in such a bad mood?
Why do you have to pry into other people's lives?
I wasn't. I just want-
I don't give a damn about what you wanted.
Hi, baby. Sorry I was late.
I don't give a damn about what you're doing. You wasted my precious time. Let's go. I'm not getting younger over here.
Don't take it personal. He's been like this all day. Just give him time to cool off.
Damn it, Savannah. Walk faster.
This place sure is ominous.
Well, it is an abandoned warehouse. What else do you expect?
All right, let's go save Star.
It will be okay, Rena.
Wait.
What?
We can't knock on the door.
And why not?
Because we're here to rescue Star. If we knock on the door, we'll never get in. We have to break in.
Sounds like my kind of mission. I'm in.
Wait a minute. I know this place.
You do?
Why do you know this place?
The place?
I just don't see why you thought it was okay to eat my bacon.
I was hungry and you had 3 pieces of bacon.
You had 6 pieces of bacon.
So?
2 of them were mine!
We get it. Shut up. Get it, all right? You ate Zach's bacon, and you're not happy about it. This is all you have been talking about, and it's rather quite annoying. We're stranded on a different side of the forest with no food, and guess what? We're separated from Star again.
I thought you stopped.
No.
I'm sorry for snapping at you. Zach told us about your dad.
That's nice.
I'm trying to be nice to you. You never once apologized for comparing your life to mine. I get it. You have a hard life too.
Do you, Sunshine? Do you really? I'm so glad that you know what it's like to grow up without a father and abusive mother. I'm so glad you understand.
Why do you have to be this way? I knew you could be a jerk, but never this big of a jerk. You know what? Never mind. I'll leave you alone.
She doesn't understand. I know I was a jerk, but I really hate how she thinks she knows me. Sometimes I wonder if I deserve to live this way. How am I supposed to walk into that courtroom when that woman in there is going to look at me like I am the screw-up and that I'm guilty? Why is she even here? Why did she suddenly decide to give a crap about me now? She never did, so why is she here?
You're a cute, Star.
Thank you, I know.
So, Star, what do you want for your birthday?
Cake.
Oof, Star, sometimes you're complicated.
Please don't get me anything.
Of course I'm gonna get you something. Look, I know we don't always get along, but you're my best friend. I'm gonna make sure you're gonna have the best damn birthday ever.
No, really, it's okay. Just having you guys present is good enough. I mean, it'll be better than all the other years.
What do you mean?
You know, it doesn't matter.
Alright then.
What about me?
Yeah, but you don't really care about me either.
What do you mean? Of course I do.
You're always pushing me away and making me feel small. Sometimes I feel like I'm just a burden to everyone. It hurts because I appreciate you all so much, but no one ever really returns the kindness, and it just hurts because now I have no one. My mom is always in a bad mood, and I know she's hurting too. and Luella is old, and who knows how long she'll be with us. But my biggest fear is that I'll wake up one morning, and she'll no longer be with us. She's my only friend I have left.
I really wish I knew how to help her. Wish she didn't bottle up all these emotions. I can't imagine how long she's been suffering.
Did you have fun with Star today?
Yeah, it was great. She brought Mr. Snuffleupagus with her.
Oh, I see. You've been spending a lot of time with her lately.
Well, yeah. I mean, with Madison at work, I really have no other choice.
Mm-hmm. Is that the real reason, Dustin?
Of course it is. I like Sydney.
Stop using Sydney as a cover and just be honest with yourself, Dustin.